This video will contain spoilers. I kind of made a mistake in the 19-14 review I made yesterday, because I said, you know, that later on in that day I'd be making a cinema review, but not actually making it till today. Whoops. Anyway, Dune Part 2, universally positive ratings, directed by Denis Villeneuve. I watched it in the cinema, along with Harry wasn't there. Binman, Dylan's cousin, and Ginger. I'll do the cast first. Actually, no, wait. There's nothing really, like, that I want to say in particular. I just want to talk about it. Not long before I left, like, I was going to leave early because I was watching CSI with my granddad, and, you know, he was planning on leaving the house to go and get my brother from school after the episode ended. And I was leaving soon anyway because I need to go to the cinema. And just before I left, Binman messaged and said, "Oh, you just want to, like, go somewhere, maybe, like, 40 minutes before it starts?" I said, sure, I was leaving early anyway. Dylan suggested McDonald's. Binman then suggested Tim Hortons. I've been lying to them, saying I've never been to Tim Hortons before. I have, I just don't feel like I've had the proper experience, because every time that I've went before yesterday, it was basically just getting the same kind of thing as you get everywhere else. Like, I always saw Tim Hortons as like a donut place. People keep on talking about the donuts, and I didn't even get donuts when I got there. I got a frappe and chicken tenders. Anyway, after we did that, they all got in my car to drive over to the cinema. And instead of being, "Oh, you know, we're sorry for talking shit about you for the past however long, you're not actually a bad driver." They're just like, "Oh, we barely survived. Dylan's clutch control sucks." Shit like that. And then after, Ben Mandel and Dylan's cousin, they, you know, their parents picked them up. I offered Ginger a lift. He said yes. I said, "Well, do you mind if I go get my dinner first?" Because I ordered from a place called, I don't know how to pronounce it, but it's like Babe Adriano's Mexicanos. It's a Mexican place. I fucked up my order. If you look at the menu, it will show you, like, can I get the instructions? It's like, step one, choose your base, and then you have a choice of burrito, bowl, quesadilla, and taco. Step two, choose your meat. I think it's pulled pork, chili con carne, vegetable. I know that vegetables and chili con carne aren't meat, but they just said choose your meat. Chicken, beef, I think that's it. And then step three, choose extras if you want them. And it's like onions, more meat, a couple other things. No matter what you get, doesn't matter if it's taco, quesadilla, bowl, or burrito, they'll come with the same things inside them. You've got rice, beans, cheese, salsa, and sour cream. I want all that to get the sort of traditional burrito. And I ordered it on the phone. I said, you know, can I have a chicken burrito? But I guess me and the guy on the phone sort of confused each other, because what I meant was burrito. Everything that comes with a burrito, I want my meat to be chicken. But he took it to be, I want just chicken. So my burrito came with just chicken and rice. It was good, but it does need something saucy. Anyway, cast. Austin Butler was overrated. People said that he was like Anton Chigurh in No Country for Old Men. He wasn't. There's nothing wrong with his performance. It's just average. Timothée Chalamet, Florence Pugh. I think she's going to be the main character of Dune 3 or something. I don't know. I haven't read the books. Zendaya, Rebecca Ferguson, Christopher Walken, Lea Seydoux. Jason Momoa does not make an appearance in this. Stellan Skarsgård, Javier Bardem, Dave Bautista, who he had more of like a presence, I guess, than Austin Butler, because Austin Butler is just this fighter, like he lives to fight, whereas Bautista in the first film was a guy, he was in the film, whereas in this he gets quite angry, he smashes a guy's face into like a monitor. That was nice to watch. Josh Brolin. Bin Laden went to the bathroom during the scene where Josh Brolin's character came back. And when Bin Laden came back from the bathroom, he was like, wait, what the fuck? Why is he here? He died in the first one? I was like, he did? I don't... Are you not getting confused with Jason Momoa? And then he just didn't respond to me. He's looking old in that film. I get that he's 56, but still. Timberlake Nelson, who I did not know was in this. David Dasmalchian is not in this. Stephen McKinley, fuck, what's his last name? Henderson is not in this. Robert Rodriguez is not in this. I was half yawning. Okay. The film is great. It did feel like it was falsely advertised. I feel like they kind of advertised it like a war film, but it just isn't. There's more action in this than there is in the first one, but it's still not war. Although the end of this does kind of promote Dune 3 as a war film. I didn't know that the Fremen name of the planet is Dune. I just assumed that Arrakis is what it always was. And I kind of like the fact that they call it Dune, because when it comes to the sequels, you have like Children of Dune, or it's, I don't know if it's Children of Dune or Children of the Dune, but I kind of like that. I thought Frank Herbert or Herbert had just called it Dune because sand. Trying to think what else to say. A couple of my friends seemed a bit disappointed by it, which I sort of get, but what I'm confused by is the fact that they weren't disappointed by Dune 1 when... Because they knew, well, part 2 is coming, but I mean, we know part 3 is coming, so like, What's up? I feel like with the possibility of Paul becoming the villain, that could be done really well. Once again, I haven't read the books, but I wasn't a fan of the way that they did Eren being the villain in AOT, because it kind of felt like fans of the show were supporting Eren when Eren deserves to die. Yeah. I don't know, I'll say. The Iron Claw, universally positive ratings. I watched it in the cinema. Zac Efron, Jeremy Allen White, Lily James. I think that's the only people recognizing this. I'm surprised Google didn't put in the real life people as part of the cast. I mean, they only appear through photos, but Google have put people on the cast for less, so. This film is fucking amazing. I'm not a fan of wrestling at all, but like, I'm not surprised that Jeremy Allen White took this on, because the first half of the film is, it feels nice, you know. There are a couple of setbacks, but overall, the Von Erich family are doing really well. But then the last half is just sheer tragedy, and it does remind me of how Shameless has the perfect balance of drama and comedy. There's not really any comedy in this, but the sort of uplifting scenes, them winning, Kevin's marriage, stuff like that. That's basically the same. And it just, I don't think I've ever felt so emotional watching a film. Because in no short time, they get you hooked on, I don't want to say the characters because it's real life people, but you know, you feel for them even though you've only known them for the past, I think it's like 40 minutes in that the first tragedy happens. I'd seen there's like articles of like Jeremy Allen White's physical transformation. I remember going like, well, what the fuck? One, when is his hair is that long? And two, he's that buff? What the f what? But obviously it was because of this. Zac Efron as well. I don't really follow him as much because there's not that much I've actually seen him in. Like, it's one episode of NCIS. I watched the majority of High School Musical 2 in Mavs class. I've seen The Greatest Showman. I've seen Baywatch, and I think that's it. So, don't follow him really that. Oh, if, I didn't finish his film, the Ted Bundy one, but I did see part of that. But you know, he's Jesus Christ. That's not an effect or anything. He wasn't wearing like a muscle suit that they were somehow able to like make it look like it's him with real muscles. He has the like that is him. The amount of dedication and that, like, you can tell they're all passionate about it because of their physical transformation. And it's just it's amazing. I don't know what else to say.